Hi, I'm Jerry Barker, vacation home specialist here in Orlando. And one of the things that we get very regularly are frequently asked questions. People ask us the same questions over and over, which is fantastic. We love answering them, but we decided we'd do a frequently asked questions video so it gives us a point of reference. Ali and I have gone over some questions that you ask us all the time. And we'll create a frequently asked questions page, and we also have our frequently asked questions video. So this may help you speed yourself along in the process of understanding everything vacation homes here in Orlando. So Ali has the questions ready, and I am going to be answering them for you today. Ali, what's our first frequently asked question?
Okay, number one. What does the Jerry Barker Group do?
What does the Jerry Barker Group do? Well, we help people from all over the world go through the education process of understanding what it takes to own and manage a vacation home here in Orlando. We go through the whole education with you, and we also help find you the correct properties. We acquire that property for you through the contract scenario where both realtors, and we actually have a real estate brokerage. The Jerry Barker Group is a real estate brokerage. That is our one hat. Our other hat is the vacation home specialist hat. And as a vacation home specialist, we are going to do all the other stuff as opposed to just the property side of it, all the things like property management and insurance and all that information that you're going to require to be successful in your vacation home. That is what we do at the Jerry Barker Group.
Very good. Thank you. Can you tell us what is the guide?
The guide, this is the guide right here. The guides are the Orlando Vacation Home Buyer's Guide. And this is a book that I wrote approximately 5 years ago. Really interesting story. This book actually started off as emails. And somebody would ask me, what is homeowners association fees? And I would write a big email about homeowners association fees. So when people kept on asking me the same question, I'd be able to cut and paste that email. And then I decided that that was unnecessary work. So I created a website, and I took that email and put that into a website so you could go to the Jerry Barker Group and check out homeowners association fees. And then I decided at some point along the way to take all of those web pages and put them into a book, and this is the hard copy book. So these are actually emails, started off as emails, they became web pages, and then eventually they were all correlated and put together, and it becomes the Orlando Vacation Home Buyer's Guide. It is a book that will give you all the basics about understanding, about buying, managing, and all the red tape and all the bits and pieces. It's a great read. It is absolutely free. We offer it both in the hardback copy, a digital download. You can go to jerrybarker.com/guide and you put in your email address in there, and it will automatically send you a link where you can download a PDF and you can read it at your leisure. It is a must start if you're considering buying a vacation home here in Orlando. Start with the guide, and the guide will guide you where you need to go.
Excellent. Thank you. Okay, next up, what does the Jerry Barker Group assist with, and what does the Jerry Barker Group not assist with?
Well, think about us like your quarterback. That's a good American term, right? So we really try and help with everything that you're going to need to know. We understand that all of our clients are either out of state or out of country. So what we try to do is we try to make sure that you get all the information that you're going to require as far as the buying process and everything you need to go through as far as that's concerned. If you need to travel here, you need to go look at resorts, you need to look at houses, we set all that up for you. So that's all of the real estate part. And the other part of it is all the business part, and we help you and set you up with all of those parts as well. That's what we do. We do everything basically other than pay for it, and that's what we don't do. So the thing that we do not do is we do not help with the financing side of it. We can introduce you to financial vendors that we've worked with, or our clients have worked with, and that we have approved over the years. We actually don't do any of the management, we don't do any of the insurance, we don't do any of the financing, but what we do is we make sure during the roadmap that you get introduced to all of those people. So think of us as just the center point, overseeing the entire program for you, making sure that everything goes according to plan, and introducing to you all the people that's going to make you successful in it. So that's what we do, and that's what we don't do.
Great, thank you. What is the geographical area of your expertise?
Yes, that is actually a great question, because we get people coming in all the time and they want to buy a house in the Florida Keys or over in Sarasota or on the beaches in the coast or wherever it may be. We don't do Florida. We are very specific. We are in the Southwest Orlando area, which for a lot of people is known as Kissimmee or Davenport. That's kind of the general names that's used for that area. It's actually really known as the Four Corners, where the four counties come together. That's what is the Orlando short-term rental zone area. And that's really, really important, because you want to buy a property that's in the Orlando short-term rental area if you want to rent it out. If you buy it outside of that area, there's a very good chance that you won't be able to rent it out. And you're not going to be very happy if that happens, because you go and buy a house and then you find out that you can't rent it out, and that's not going to be a good day. So everything that we deal with, unless you specifically ask for something outside of that, and it's very rare that happens, is going to be in the Orlando short-term rental zone. It's a very specific area, southwest of basically Disney. It's all within about a 20-minute drive from any of our locations to the parks. That's exactly the area geographically that we deal with.
Okay, great. Can you tell us what are the additional fees that somebody can expect to pay?
Additional fees. Well, here's a good place to start. When you're buying a vacation home in Orlando, one of the things that you will want to do is you want to go through that whole concept of what are your outs and what are your ins. And we have a webpage, jerrybarker.com/calculator. It's an interactive calculator I designed way back in the day, and I designed it so I could run performers for people to give them a rough idea of what they could expect to pay in and what they could expect to pay out and how much that would turn out to be, plus minus or whatever the case may be, at the end of a year. So that's a great page to visit first, because that's going to give you a lot of the general costs that are involved in ownership and that you will have to pay on a vacation home. Some of those things are like property taxes, your HOA fees, your insurance costs. Those are kind of general costs. And then on top of that, you will have things like your property management fees and your marketing fees, etc. That's all on the business side. On the real estate side, you will have, actually, if you're a cash buyer, there's generally not an awful lot of costs. You can probably expect about 1% or maybe less than that of the actual cost of the property, if you calculate that, and that's usually about right. That comes and goes a little bit depending on various different things. Some of the locations are more expensive to buy into the others, but it's usually not by very much. But we can certainly break down all those costs for you. That's one of the things that we will do. We'll go through the numbers, so when you decide you want to buy a certain house in a certain location, we can do one of those ledgers for you. We actually use exactly the same calculator. And we'll do one for you, we'll send it to you, and then you can have that as a baseline. So when you're moving forward, you can go back and you can look at the listing, you can see the taxes, the homeowners association fees, superimpose them into the interactive calculator, and you will always have a good idea of what the costs and fees are likely to be. And that's really important. You don't have to take anybody else's word for it. You don't have to believe somebody else what they tell you. You can actually do it yourself, and then you will know.
Great, thank you. The our next question is, that we get a lot, who will manage our property?
Who will manage your property? That is a good question. Well, that depends. It's going to be your property management company. And who will that be? That again depends on where you buy. A lot of the times the properties are already in a program. They are vacation homes. If you're buying a vacation home as a resale, chances are it's already in a program. It's already with a property management company. So the first thing we want to do is figure out who they are and find out if they're a good management company. If they're a good management company, then we can stay with them. If we don't feel as though it's a management company that suits what you're trying to achieve, and that's a whole other conversation with it in itself. But if it turns out it's not a management company that works for what you're trying to do, then we can recommend other management companies and you can move over to another management company. So the answer to that question is nobody has any idea at the moment, but we do recommend half a dozen really good property management companies. They're all a little bit different. They all have kind of different things that they'll do better or less for you. And that's why getting to know who you are and what you're trying to achieve in your vacation home is really important, so that we can match a management company to your needs.
The next question is, who will market our property?
Marketing is kind of like property management in a lot of ways. A lot of the times the management companies offer a marketing service. Property management companies generally wear two hats. Property management, obviously that's what a property management company is, but also property marketing. And generally, the property management side of it is really a loss leader for management companies. It's not a big money maker for them, although some people think it might be, it actually is not. Where they actually make their money is on the marketing side. So they market your property, and when they market your property and rent it out, then they take a percentage of the marketing fee. It's usually 15%, some are a little less, some are a little more, but give or take, it's roughly 15%. And that's where they make their money, and they, I'll tell you what, they work really hard for it. So really, property managers are both things. Management companies and marketing companies, and of course in many occasions nowadays with VRBO and Airbnb and all those programs that go with it, a lot of people do their own marketing, and that's something that we very highly recommend you work with a management company that will allow you to do that, and then in those circumstances you can set up your own programs and you can bring in your own renters. You're going to save a little bit of money on the commission, but the management companies are great, and they're well worth those fees that they'll charge you. And many of the management companies are 100% full service. If you don't want to do anything at all to your property, you just want to call up a couple of times a year and say, I want to stay for the next 2 weeks, black that out, and the rest of the time you manage it and look after it, there are management companies that are excellent at doing that. So wherever you sit in the spectrum, whether it's full management or if you want to take a real active role in managing your property, that's up to you. And again, that comes under the earlier question of who will manage our property. We don't know, because until we know who you are and what you're trying to achieve, then we can't recommend a management company. So that's the long-winded answer to a short question.
No, it's a great answer though, thank you. Excellent. Next up is, will my vacation home make me money?
Will your vacation home make you money? Good question. Again, that is a how long is a piece of string question, because it depends what is the vacation home, it depends who the owners are, it depends who the management company is. By rule of thumb, and this is probably a really good way to look at it, the number one, in my opinion, the number one benefit of owning a vacation home is basically having a beautiful home in Florida that you can use, your family can use anytime you like, and have someone else pay for it. And I would probably say 65-70% of our clients, that's their goal. It's not about retiring on the money they're going to get from their vacation home. It's all about getting the great use of it, family memories. And you know, with a little bit of luck, it appreciates over time. You make a little bit of money on it, and basically, you know, after X amount of years, you have a vacation home basically that somebody else has paid for. And that's really the goal. If you start going into the making money part of it, then you start running into situations where you really need to do improvements, you need to be at a certain value point so you can get the revenues back. Yes, we have clients that actually make quite a lot of money on their vacation homes. But I would say the vast majority of our clients are pretty much the break-evens. Many of them are quite happy. They don't want to run a lot of people through their vacation homes, so they don't rent it out that much. It's probably one of the things that people don't understand the most about the business of vacation homes is not everybody is just trying to make money. A lot of people are very content to have that great facility, use whenever they want. Somebody else is paying the majority of the costs and the fees for having it. They're absolutely delighted. And if you're one of them, I'll tell you, that is probably the best place to be when looking at Orlando vacation homes.
Great, great. Next up, ready?
Sure.
What monthly or annual costs can I expect?
Monthly and annual costs? Well, the base costs are going to be your property taxes. You have to pay property taxes every year. You're not going to get away with that. That's a given, and that depends. Probably a common amount I would probably suggest for a kind of standard six-bedroom, $600,000 house is probably around $5,000, $6,000 a year. That's your probably one of your biggest costs. Insurance, property insurance, you have to pay that, of course. Give or take $1,500 to $2,000 if you take out an umbrella policy on top of that, which is really important to do. It's probably a few more $100 on your umbrella policy. Of course, you'll have your power bills, and that depends on the size of the house and how much it's used, but you know, you're probably talking a few hundred dollars a month on power bills. On top of that, you'll have your homeowners association fees. Nearly every location has fees. They vary depending on what the amenities are. The more amenities, the more the homeowners association fees. Association fees are spread throughout all the owners, so everybody pays an equal amount, and that covers the things like the guarded gated security, the clubhouse, the facilities, the pool, the landscaping. All of that is paid equally by all the owners. And that varies, again, it depends on the location, but you're probably looking on average for a resort be $4,500 a month on that. And that's really the bulk, I believe, of the running costs. And then another side of it, you have your management costs, management fees, and your commissions. And then on top of that, if there's any extra maintenance, you know, if you end up deciding you want to do some furniture updates or theme rooms or whatever it might be, those might be, every few years you might want to do some standardization, you know, clean the air filters, shampoo the carpets, that kind of stuff. But again, those are all kind of minor stuff. So that's kind of the bulk of it.
Great. Okay, great. What is the difference between a resort and a community?
Yeah, so that's just a good question, because a lot of people see just houses and they're just looking through houses, and they're pretty specific in the marketplace. What you find is that there are major resorts. And what is a resort? So resort, we associate a resort with generally manned gated. So there's somebody there when you drive up, you don't get in until you talk to somebody and you're supposed to be there for a reason, which is great. A lot of people love that, and rightly so. And then when you get inside, it's beautifully manicured grounds, palm trees, and nicely looked after with a clubhouse with the facilities, the pool, maybe a restaurant, etc. So it's a real full service resort. You can spend a lot of time in there. A lot of people don't even have to leave a resort because of everything that's going on in there. So that's a resort. And then you can get tweeners, which are kind of bits and pieces. They're maybe gated communities with some variety of a clubhouse or a pool, which are kind of in between a resort and a community. And then you've just got base communities. And communities are just like a community. It's just a street you drive into with houses, and it's called, the Okie Dokie community, and doesn't have any facilities, but it's got houses. And you can buy those houses and you can rent those out. So you really have resorts and communities, and then a little bit of tweeners in between, which would be a tweener.
Very good, thank you. Staying on the resort sort of subject, one question we get a lot is, if I want to buy a vacation home in Orlando, where should I buy?
Well, you have to buy, first of all, you have to buy in the short-term rental zone. So that's Southwest Orlando. If you're buying a vacation home and you intend to rent it, so that's a must. You have to stay in that, what they call the Golden Triangle, and it's an area southwest of Walt Disney World. As far as specific locations, and we get it all the time, people call us up and say, what's the best place to buy? And again, it's kind of the analogy that I use for people is, it's kind of, somebody just called you up and said, I want to buy a car, what's the best car to buy? And it's kind of like, well, it depends. If you got a big family, you need a Suburban, you need an SUV, what do you need? A sports car. It's a little bit like that to a certain extent. So where you should buy is going to come down to what you're actually trying to achieve. If you are looking more to invest, or if you're looking more for a family, or your price point. So there's a lot of things that go into that. Generally, what I'm going to tell you is you want to buy in a resort. That's, in my opinion, if you're here and you're going to buy a vacation home in Orlando, you should try and get in a resort if you possibly can. I think the benefits of a resort outweigh a community or a tweener in between. So I would stick to the resorts unless there's something specific you want in a community or a location you want in that community. But start off with the resorts. There's a pretty decent spread now from the older resorts all the way up to the latest super resorts. So that gives you a pretty good spread in different houses, house sizes, and price points. So there really isn't any reason not to buy in a resort unless there's a house or a situation that you particularly want. So I would suggest you have to buy in the short-term rental zone, and I would suggest you would buy in a resort in a short-term rental zone.
Are there any hidden fees?
Hidden fees? Not that I'm aware of. What would be a good hidden fee? I think probably the only thing that I would suggest might be a hidden fee, which is not really a hidden fee, are costs that you'll incur throughout the period of ownership. If something breaks, you have to paint the property. That's all the kind of maintenance. So maintenance, people really don't talk about that very much. There may be some additional fees with management companies. Credit card fees is one of them, for example. Nobody really talks about that, but some management companies If they take credit cards cost them money. So if they're taking a lot of credit cards, they might charge you a 2%, you know, on a deal on a credit card. That's possibly a hidden fee, but generally we know what all the fees are, and we'll let you know what those are up front. But there's certainly nothing that's going to come and wallop you. You're going to get landed with a huge bill. Actually, let me reiterate that, because you can get what's called special assessments. And it's very rare, but it was a special assessment. Well, a special assessment on a community, for example, let's take a situation. Something happens to the resort and everybody has to pay for it. So, for example, the road needs to get paved, or something breaks and it's an expensive item and they don't have enough money in the reserves for the homeowners association to cover that. And what they might do is they might put out a special assessment. So they might ask everybody for $200 or $500 or whatever that is breaking down into its increments. Every home will have to pay their share. I wouldn't say it's a hidden fee. It's just something that can come up. It's very, very rare. I can't actually remember of any situation off the top of my head that a special assessment's come in, but I know they do happen. So there's really no way to protect yourself from that. It's just stuff that happens, especially with a really old resort. So you might just want to bear that in mind if it's something that's 15 or 20 years old and they need to spend some additional monies on something. You can ask, you can have your realtor ask the homeowners association, or when you buy a property, one of the things that your realtor is going to give you is a HOA disclosure. And on the HOA disclosure, we'll actually have the information, or it should have the information, for somebody at the homeowners association. And I would always recommend, even though that homeowners association disclosure has the costs, etc., on the disclosure, it's probably worth giving them a call anyway, introducing yourself and say, I'm thinking of buying a vacation home in this resort. Are these fees right? I've got a piece of paper that says it's $400 a month. Is that right? What does that include? Are we getting any special assessments coming up? And they're duty bound to give you all that information. So you will actually have the tools to check all that yourself. So I would probably suggest that's probably as hidden as I can come up with on short notice.
Yes, not many to choose from, which is good.
Yeah.
And tell us a little bit about the capital contribution.
Capital contribution, that's part of joining a homeowners association. Most homeowners association have a capital contribution fee. What does that mean? Well, it's very much for or to save, in many cases, special assessments. Not all communities have them, but most of the bigger ones do. So what is that? So when you join, or a new person buys a property in a resort, then there's a joining fee. It's actually called a capital contribution, and it can be a couple of $100s. I've seen them as much as, I think some of them are about $3,000. We saw one, it's $3,000, I think. It was Emerald Island. Emerald Island Resort, for example, is a $3,000, which is the highest one. And normally they're about $1,000, aren't they? Something about
$1,500,
$1,000. What does that do? Well, what they do is they put all that into a pot. That's kind of what we were talking about earlier. If they don't have the reserves to cover something, and a big amount, then they'll come to you for a special assessment. Well, the capital contribution, if they get that for every new buyer, goes into that pot, and therefore they don't have to come for a special assessment. So that's one of the reasons why we don't see a lot of special assessments, because the capital contribution fees for new buyers cover that. And it's only if something was over the top of that you'd get a special assessment. But yeah, that's a really good question. Capital contribution fees, nearly at every resort you'll see about this. So that's a cost that will be incurred at closing. That's part of your closing cost, let's call it that.
Yeah. Okay. Great. So if I own a home already, can you help me sell it?
Of course. We are a full service brokerage, the Jerry Barker Group. We're a very small brokerage. We never went out to be a big agent brokerage. We always decided we want to just stay small. We want to be able to help specific clients individually, take really good care of them, rather than just have dozens of agents that we don't know what they're doing or saying from a day-to-day basis. So one of the nice things about that is we can really control the quality. And I think that's probably the thing when I set out to start this company 12, 13 years ago, that's one of the things that I really wanted to do. I wanted to educate the clients. I wanted to control our product and make sure that people who were entrusting us with $500,000 of their dollars from the other side of the world knew everything that was going on and had all the necessary information. It was completely transparent. And I think that is, in my opinion, that is exceptionally important. And what happens is at some point when you go through the lifespan of owning your vacation home, at some point along the way, you're probably going to want to sell it, and we can help you do that. My wife, Alyssa, is both the broker of the Jerry Barker Group and also the listing agent, so you'll deal directly with Alyssa for the listings, and she's fantastic. She can go through all that detail. So if you do want to sell a property, and you can reach out to us, you will get Alyssa, and Alyssa will go through everything you need to know about selling your vacation home, and she'll make that process smooth and easy and enjoyable fun. So you get the best of both worlds when you have Ali and I, or Roger, and Roger's right here behind the camera making sure everything goes. He's waving to you right now. The three of us help people buy, and Alyssa helps people sell. So that's our team right now.
That's it?
So yes, that's it, frequently asked questions.
Yeah.
There you are, frequently asked questions. That's hopefully will save you a little bit of time. Of course, you can call us up anytime you like, and you can ask us the same questions. We'll be happy to go over it in even more detail. But hopefully that'll at least go over some of the basics for you, so you get an idea of how the process is, who we are, and how it goes. I would also very highly encourage you to go to our website at www.jerrybarker.com/guide. Download yourself a copy of this book. It is absolutely free and a great place to start your education for a vacation home. Once you've read this book, then you will want to contact us on the website. You will get Ali here, who will start you through the process, get you on the roadmap, make sure you know everything you need to know. And at some point along the way, you'll get to meet me or Roger, and we'll start showing you houses and properties or videos and doing all the great stuff that we do to make sure that you get a great service and a great property in your Orlando vacation home purchase. That's it from me. That's it from Ali. That's it from Roger behind you. If there's anything else, please reach out to us. We're here to help. Thank you very much for watching.